Can he hear you? Can the dead hear the living? If so, then when your best friend dies, it doesn't matter. You can go over there and still say, how's it going, man? You know, life's good. I got a new, you know, channel on YouTube, a new page on Facebook. Life is good. How's everything with you? And, you know, he sent him a text message. Can people, do you see people going? Now, who does that, by the way? The kuffar. They go, they have a conversation with the dead person. And, you know, to us, this is something reprehensible. There's no such thing. There's no such thing. Now, we will explain, because some people have a misunderstanding. First, brothers and sisters in Islam, the Quran specifically and directly addresses this issue. Two ayat that cannot be refuted or disputed concerning this matter. The first one, Allah says to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إِنَّكَ لَا تُسْمِعُ الْمَوْتَى وَلَا تُسْمِعُ الصُّمَّ الدُّعَاءَ إِذَا وَلَّوْ مُدْبِرِينَ. Verily, you cannot make the dead hear. You cannot make the dead hear. And you cannot make the deaf hear the call when they turn around and retreat. Allah is telling the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the same way you're giving da'wah to these kuffar, and they're not hearing you, they're not hearing you. Why? Because they are just like the dead people who don't hear. You give da'wah, there's no benefit. Who does that remind you of? The dead people, you speak to them, and there's no benefit. You see the analogy. This is clear. This is the tafsir of the ulama. No one denies this tafsir. So you cannot make the kuffar hear the invitation to Islam, for they are like the dead who do not hear either. The second ayah, وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْأَحْيَاءُ وَلَا الْأَمْوَاتُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُسْمِعُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُسْمِعٍ مَنْ فِي الْقُبُورِ. Verily, and the living and the dead are not equal. Are they equal? We just said, are they equal? No, they're not equal. We have a whole other way than that of the dead people. We can go do salah, we can do many things. There, it's over for them. So Allah said they're not alike. Then Allah went on to say, verily Allah makes whomever He wills hear, and you cannot make those in the graves hear you. Listen to that. وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُسْمِعٍ مَنْ فِي الْقُبُورِ. You know qadr. And you cannot make those in the graves hear. Who's saying this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Telling who? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. You cannot make the people in the grave hear you. So when these people go on and call on these people, they don't even hear them. And we will see the ayat in the refutation of that. طيب. Now why do they insist? Why do they insist that it is okay to do what they're doing? Because of two narrations which they have misunderstood and misinterpreted. And we will deal with these narrations, so we will know. The hadith of Abu Talha, he reported, on the day of the battle of Badr, the Prophet ﷺ ordered that the bodies of 24 of the dead of Quraysh will be thrown in a foul, stinky well in Badr. There's a well, you know the well, where there's water. It was bad, busted, stinky, whatever, the dead animals there, Allahu A'lam was there. He ordered that 24 of their bodies will be thrown where? In there. There's no hurmah for the disbelievers. There's no yani honoring them or respecting them in this particular sense, especially those ones. Otherwise, if a non-Muslim dies, then you bury him in the ground as well. But you don't give him the janazah prayer. Tayyip, on the third day, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mounted his animal and he head out. The Sahaba said he must be going to something important. So they went after him. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it there, he began addressing those in the well, calling them, addressing them name by name. Oh, so and so, the son of so and so. And oh, so and so, the son of so and so. He mentioned their names. Then he said, we have found that which our Lord promised to be true. Have you found that which Allah has promised you to be true? We have found victory. We have found the nasr which Allah promised us. Have you found the punishment which you were asking for? Now, this is a very important incident. Now, if you just stop here, actually, what does it appear? It appears like the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ is addressing dead people. But you have to read the continuation. So, Umar said, you know Umar. Umar is not your average man. Umar, the revelation came in agreement with him and in disagreement with even Abu Bakr and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than once. More than once. Like the captives of the battle where Abu Bakr said, you know, set them free, we'll have him teach us, you know, something. And Umar said, And Allah revealed the revelation in agreement with Umar. The one whom the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if there was to be a prophet after me, it would be Umar. Umar knew the deen. Umar knew Islam. When he saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam address these dead people, he said, what are you saying to these bodies without souls? What are you saying to these bodies without souls? Do they hear? He's confused. رضي الله عنه. Do they hear? For Allah, the Majestic says, verily you cannot make the dead hear. The one we mentioned earlier, right? إِنَّكَ لَا تُسْمِعُ الْمَوْتَى. Now, Umar had an understanding that you cannot make them hear, and you're speaking to them, you know, what you're addressing bodies without souls. Do they hear? Now, if he was wrong, according to the agreement of the ulama, that the job, one of the jobs of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was to correct people. In such instances, it must be done instantly. There's no ta'khir. There should be no ta'khir in bayan al-hukum. When the situation is of this nature, had Umar been wrong, first the Messenger of Allah should have said to him, no, who told you? The dead people here. Dead people here. This ayah doesn't mean that. And he would have explained, as in the ayah about, you know, those who believe and they do not mix their iman with dhulm. And the sahaba said, you know, dhulm? You know, lahum al-amn. These will have security. These will be the victorious one. The sahaba looked at themselves, which one of us doesn't have dhulm, oppression? Which one of us doesn't wrong himself? So they were troubled by this ayah. That the ayah says that unless you have to be a perfect believer basically, for you, you know, to be safe. So they went to the Messenger of Allah, said, Ya Rasulullah, this ayah is heavy. It's saying, you know, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, and the rest of the ayah. He said, no, dhulm here does not mean the sins. Dhulm means shirk. Have you not heard the statement of Luqman? إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. So he explained to the Sahaba who misunderstood an ayah, that dhulm in that ayah meant shirk. If you believe in Allah and you don't mix it with shirk, you will be safe. It doesn't mean wrongdoing, which is any sin is a dhulm to oneself. So we learn from the seerah then, that when the time, when it was necessary, the Prophet ﷺ would do what? He would correct the Sahaba on the understanding of the ayah. Like in many other occasions, right? When he mentioned, فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى وَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. Speaking, he has used this ayah to explain the hadith about the one who should not depend on qadr, rather he should strive. I'm giving you various examples which I'm sure you know of. Point being, if Umar misunderstood and the Sahaba were present, the Prophet ﷺ would have explained that this is a misunderstanding, Umar, about the ayah. But he didn't. He acknowledged the understanding, however he said. He said, alayhi salatu wasalam, by him in whose hand lies the soul of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you did not hear better than them what I just said. Now, you did not hear better than them what I just said. Now listen, Qatada added, Allah brought them back, between parentheses, momentarily. Allah brought them back in order to make them hear as means of scorn and belittlement, so that they will feel regret and remorse. See how they understood it? Allah brought them back momentarily, just so they will hear this belittlement, this scolding from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to increase them in regret. So this is what? An exception to the rule. An exception to the rule. You don't believe me? Let me give you another supporting evidence for that. Ibn Umar narrated the same incident, which is also found in Bukhari. And in that narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, verily, at this moment, they hear what I'm saying. At this moment, now only, they hear what I'm saying. When they went back to Aisha, And they told her the story. Aisha said, what the Prophet ﷺ meant was, now they know that what I used to tell them is the truth. Then she recited, verily you cannot make the dead hear. إِنَّكَ لَا تُسْمِعُ الْمَوْتَ. So now Umar and Aisha, both are of the understanding that the ayah mean, you cannot make the dead hear. So after she explained what happened, she commented. She referred to the ayah, that this is an exception to the rule. If someone wants to go against Umar and Aisha, then this is their business. But this is deviance. These are the Sahaba. And we don't know of a Sahabi who understood otherwise. We don't know of a Sahabi who understood that all the dead hear. So now they want to go against the Sahaba. If you go against the Sahaba, you're on the wrong path. That's not the path to Jannah. The path to Jannah is obeying Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, according to the understanding of the early generations, with the Sahaba on the top of the list. You go against these, you're gone. You're gone. But you will not be going where you want to go. That's the first hadith which they quote, and they use it as an evidence for their deviance. There's another hadith. The hadith of Anas, radiyallahu anhu wa arda. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that when the deceased is placed in the grave and buried, and then the companions, the people who are with him who bury him, he hears the shuffle of their feet as they walk away, then the two angels will come and make him sit down and ask him. So they say that the hadith mentions that the deceased, once he's put in the grave, he hears what? The footsteps, the shuffles of the feet of those who are walking away. What do we say about this? What we said about the first. Do they hear them speaking? Don't they make dua? Is it in a sunnah to say, Allahumma thabbithu inda su'al? Oh Allah, give him firmness at the time of the questioning. Did the hadith say they hear what the people are saying? No. They strictly only hear the shuffle of the feet of the people as they walk away. Khalas. Two exceptions to the rule. And you must understand the hadith in the light of the Quran. Because Allah told us in Surah Al-Imran that the kitab, fihi ayatun muhkamat. Hunna ummul kitab. وأخر متشابهات فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة وابتغاء تأويله. In the Quran which Allah sent down, there are ayat which are firm, entirely clear, and they are the mother of the book. And others that are ambiguous, that are not entirely clear. Then Allah told us, those who have deviance in their heart, they will follow the ayat and the ahadith which have more than one interpretation. Why? Seeking fitna and seeking false interpretation. The Prophet ﷺ said concerning this ayah, when you see these people as that Allah Azza wa Jal described, when you see them going after the mutashabih, know that these are the ones whom Allah described in the Quran, so be careful of them. He was warning us against someone who will get a hadith that is an exception and generalize it over everything in Islam. He will ignore the ayah, ignore the hadith, ignore the tafsir of the sahaba, because now his mind wants to accept this one hadith. Allah said these are the people in whose hearts there is what? Deviance. Clear? Beautiful. Tayyib. So that puts an end. They cannot hear.